We definitely had one thrilling fall classic between two very tough 100-win teams in the Los Angeles Dodgers and the Houston Astros. They're the eighth pair of 100-win teams to meet in World Series history and first pair since 1970. It's been a 29-year wait since the Dodgers' last World Series appearance in which they won, and it's the Astros' franchise's second World Series appearance. Their only one was in 2005, back when they were still in the National League, but both teams were going in strong, as the Astros went a perfect 6-0 at home, while the Dodgers defeated the defending champions Chicago Cubs, and only lost one game in their division and championship series. So let's do a recap of this exciting World Series matchup, starting with Game 1 at Dodger Stadium between the two aces Clayton Kershaw and Dallas Keuchel. And a game between two aces usually brings a lower scoring game because they don't make too many mistakes. But the first mistake came from Keuchel on his very first pitch, giving up a solo shot to the Dodgers' leadoff man Chris Taylor. On the other side, Kershaw put up a near-perfect performance, striking out 11 batters in 7 innings pitched, and only allowed one run to Alex Bregman's home run in the 4th inning, which tied the game at 1. And then the tie was broken when Justin Turner hit the heroic 2-out, 2-run home run off of Keuchel, so the Dodgers took the first game 3-1. On to the epic and insane Game 2, the Astros struck first in this one with 3 singles in the 3rd inning to score a run, as Alex Bregman's 1-out RBI single actually knocked off center fielder Chris Taylor's cap, and actually bounced straight to left fielder Jock Peterson, which saved a run or two, because that allowed starting pitcher Rich Hill to minimize the damage by striking out the next two batters. Jock Peterson opened the scoring for LA in the 5th inning with a 2-out solo dinger to even the game at 1. Then in the bottom of the 6th inning, Corey Seager got the lead for them with his 2-out 2-run shot, making it 3-1. So Houston starter Justin Verlander's night ended after 6 innings, only allowing 2 hits, which were those 2 home runs. But Houston couldn't afford to go down 2-0 in the series, so in the top of the 8th, Alex Bregman started the comeback when he hit the ground rule double off the tip of right fielder Yasiel Puig's glove when he dove and failed to catch it. And Carlos Correa finally solves the Dodgers bullpen that was on a 28-game scoreless inning streak by cashing in Bregman with an RBI single off of closer Kenley Jansen, who was asked to make a 6-out save. Then in the 9th, Marwin Gonzalez completes it with a solo home run which forced the game to extras. And that gave Jansen his first postseason blown save, after he had converted an MLB record 12 postseason saves. And the Astros kicked off the extra innings in a big way, with Jose Altuve and Carlos Correa smashing back-to-back jacks off of pitcher Josh Fields to lead it 5-3. They're the first pair to hit back-to-back home runs in extra innings in World Series history. But in the bottom of the 10th inning, it was the Dodgers' turn, with Yasiel Puig blasting one out to pull it to 5-4. Then they managed to tie it from an RBI single from Kike Hernandez to bring the game to the 11th. Then it was George Springer's turn to lift one out of the park, firing a 2-run shot off pitcher Brandon McCarthy for another 2-run lead at 7-5. But could the Dodgers push for another inning? Charlie Culberson connects on a 2-out pitch for a solo home run to make things interesting at 7-6. So it came down to Puig who homered in the 10th, but this time he struck out. And with that, the Astros managed to tie the series at 1 game apiece heading over to Houston. It was actually the first World Series win in Astros franchise history, and it was an intense back-and-forth thriller. Actually, the whole World Series was a back-and-forth thriller, and roller coaster of emotions. The game had 8 total home runs, most in World Series history, and the 5 homers in extra innings is the most ever in MLB regular and postseason history. Moving on to Game 3 featuring starters Yu Darvish for LA and Lance McCullers Jr. for Houston. And it was an ugly one for Darvish, who just didn't have his stuff. The damage came in the 2nd inning. First, he gave up a solo homer to Yuli Gurriel to start it off. Next, Josh Reddick hit a double and Evan Gaddis drew a walk. Then Marwin Gonzalez singled to bring in Reddick, and Brian McCann singled to score Gaddis. Last but not least, Alex Bregman hits a sac fly to cash in Gonzalez to make it 4-0. Darvish couldn't finish the inning, so he only lasted 1 2/3. That was his shortest career start, while allowing 6 hits, 1 walk, 4 earned runs, and no strikeouts. But the Dodgers got on the board with 1 run in the top of the 3rd. But the Astros would get that run back later on in the bottom of the 5th. The Dodgers tried to claw back scoring 2 runs, one from Yasiel Puig's RBI groundout, and another from a Brad Peacock wild pitch. But that's all they'll get, and Houston would win it 5-3, and took the series lead 2-1, as they continued to go perfect at Minute Maid Park with 7 home wins. The Astros only used one reliever in that game in Peacock, who picked up his first career save. And boy, it was a big one, going 3 2/3 innings, throwing 4 strikeouts and only 1 walk. The Dodgers just didn't play a very good game, making mistakes and committed 2 errors. So they looked to bounce back in Game 4, with Alex Wood taking the mound against Houston starter Charlie Morton. And boy, it was a pitcher's duel, as the first run came in the bottom of the 6th, when George Springer belted one out to break Wood's no-hitter. But the Dodgers would strike back right away against Charlie Morton in the top of the 7th, with Cody Bellinger, who's had one heck of a rookie season, but was in an 0-13 slump with 8 strikeouts this World Series, and finally awakens with a double, and would later score off a Logan Forsythe RBI single to tie it up at 1-1. And then in the ninth, it was Bellinger again, delivering a double off of Astros closer Ken Giles to score Corey Seager to take the lead. Austin Barnes hit a sac fly to add to the lead, and the massive three-run bomb off of pitcher Joe Musgrove by Jock Peterson, who was going crazy around the bases, you like that, that extended the lead to 6-1. Alex Bregman hit a solo shot in the bottom of the ninth, but that was it. The only two hits the Dodgers gave up were the two solo home runs, and they finally solved the Astros' home spell to even up the series again, which guaranteed that the series was going back to Dodger Stadium. But who would carry the lead back to LA? So let's see who wanted it more in the wild Game 5. And you know the Astros will want that 3-2 lead to try to win it in LA. So it was back to the Cy Young pitchers Clayton Kershaw and Dallas Keuchel. But the Astros struggled right off the bat. Keuchel gave up a 2-RBI single to Logan Forsythe after loading the bases to put the Dodgers up by 2 runs. Then on Forsythe's base steal, first baseman Yuli Gurriel threw wide to second baseman Jose Altuve to allow Kike Hernandez to score to get the early 3-0 lead. And in the top of the fourth, Forsythe struck a double, and Austin Barnes brought him home on his RBI single. Keuchel failed to get out of the fourth inning and only lasted 3 2/3, but Houston would bail him out in the bottom of the fourth. After a George Springer walk and an Altuve single, Carlos Correa hits an RBI double to put the Astros on the board. And then Gurriel steps in and crushes a 3-run homer off Kershaw to tie the game at 4. Top of the 5th, it was Cody Bellinger's turn, belting a 3-run shot of his own for the 7-4 lead, off Colin McHugh after he committed a couple walks. Bottom of the 5th, Altuve wanted a turn too, destroying a Kenta Maeda pitch to center for his own 3-run shot, after Kershaw was knocked out allowing a couple of walks. And the game was even at 7. The Dodgers aced through 4 2/3 innings and was charged with 6 earned runs. But the Dodgers would take the lead again in the top of the 7th, with Bellinger again shooting a liner to the center fielder Springer, who missed the catch, so Hernandez, who was at first, was able to come in to score. It was 8-7 LA going into the bottom half of the 7th. The Dodgers manager Dave Roberts elected to bring in Brandon Morrow, who had already appeared in the first 4 games, which was quite a lot to ask from the reliever, so Springer took advantage of that opportunity to redeem himself, completely smashing a solo shot to tie it again. And then the Astros would go in front thanks to an Altuve RBI double. But they still wanted more, with Correa shooting a rainbow shot out of the park to put them up 11-8. Morrow gave up 4 runs on 4 hits on only 6 pitches. The Dodgers would try to claw back though, as Corey Seager hits an RBI double to get one in the 8th to trail 11-9. But Brian McCann would take it right back, hitting a solo homer to make it 12-9. Top of the 9th, the Dodgers didn't want to give up just yet. Bellinger started it off with a walk. Then Yasiel Puig stepped in and sliced a ridiculous line drive 2-run home run, and his team was only down by 1. Then Austin Barnes hit a double to set up one last chance for Chris Taylor. And on 2 outs and his final strike, Taylor delivers with a clutch RBI single to cash in Barnes for the tie. So this 12-12 game had to go to extras, but Houston would finish the job. And the hero was Alex Bregman with a man in scoring position, facing Kenley Jansen with 2 outs, lifts a clutch RBI single to end that insane and wild game, which took 5 hours and 17 minutes, second longest in World Series history. Both teams were desperate, but it was the Astros who took the much-needed 3-2 series lead. So it was a must-win Game 6 for the Dodgers, who had home field advantage. A lot of the Dodgers players were confident that they were going to take this game, so let's see how they fared against Verlander, who was looking to win his first World Series after 2 attempts with the Detroit Tigers. Let's jump to the top of the 3rd inning, where it was George Springer who drew first blood, knocking a solo shot off Dodgers starter Rich Hill. The Astros would knock Hill out of the game in the 5th inning by loading the bases, so Dave Roberts had to take a risk with Brandon Morrow, appearing in his 6th straight World Series game. But Morrow was up to the task, escaping the jam unharmed, keeping the game at 1-0. Verlander was locked in, but the Dodgers were finally able to solve him in the 6th. Austin Barnes started it off with a single, and Chase Utley was hit by a pitch. Then Chris Taylor would convert with a big RBI double down the right foul line to score Barnes and move Utley to 3rd. Corey Seager would cash in Utley on a huge drive to the outfield for the sacrifice fly to put the Dodgers on top 2-1. In the 7th, Joe Musgrove came in to replace Verlander, but had to face that guy again, Mr. Jacques You Like That Peterson. And yes, he did it again, launching that massive solo shot off Musgrove, and went crazy again around the bases and gave LA the insurance run. And that set it up for big Kenley Jansen for the dominant 6-out save. So the Dodgers successfully forced a winner-take-all Game 7. And it only seemed fitting that this incredible series was decided on a Game 7. And it was really anyone's game because the road and home teams were both even at 19 wins in World Series Game 7 history. So how did it all end out? Yu Darvish was given the chance to redeem himself in front of the home crowd after that horrific start in Game 3. But unfortunately, it was more of the same for him. First batter George Springer doubled to start the damage, where he scored off the throwing error by first baseman Cody Bellinger, throwing the ball behind Darvish, who was trying to cover first base, in a foot race against Alex Bregman, who advanced to second on the play. Then Bregman stole third base and came home on a Jose Altuve RBI groundout for the early 2-0 lead. Second inning, the Astros continued to ruin the biggest game of Darvish's life. Brian McCann walked to start the inning. Marwin Gonzalez doubled to put runners in scoring position. And even Lance McCullers Jr., the opposing starter, he pitched in on the damage to Darvish, hitting an RBI groundout to give himself the 3-0 lead. And then it was that man again, Springer, who had ended for Darvish, crushing a silencing two-run shot on a full count, extending the lead to 5-0. Springer homered in 4 straight games, becoming the first player to do that in World Series history. So again, Darvish only pitched 1 2/3 innings, this time surrendering 5 runs, one of them unearned on only 3 hits. So that sent Brandon Morrow to the mound, who would make an appearance in all 7 World Series games, only the second pitcher in history to do so. He would strike out Bregman to end the Astros' run. And from there, it was the battle of the bullpens, and they were lights out. Dave Roberts had to go to Clayton Kershaw to throw 4 zeros to try to give the Dodgers a chance. The Astros' Charlie Morton came in to shut the door for 4 innings, allowing only 1 run to the longest tenured player on the Dodgers' roster, Andre Ethier. So that run was all the Dodgers could get, as Morton picked up the biggest win of his career, and 5-1 was the final score. And there you have it, everyone. The Houston Astros are your 2017 World Series champions. It's the first title in their 56-year franchise history. George Springer was named the World Series MVP. He really bounced back after the 4 strikeouts in Game 1. He finished with a .379 average, hitting 5 home runs, 7 RBI, 3 doubles, and scored 8 runs. So a huge congratulations to the Astros and the city of Houston, especially all that they went through with Hurricane Harvey. And I want to congratulate guys like Justin Verlander, finally getting his first ring in his third try, 40-year-old Carlos Beltran can add World Series champion to his lustrous career, and even Francisco Liriano, the former Blue Jay, who was with us before being dealt at the deadline to the champion Astros. What a great year of baseball, with the World Baseball Classic returning to kick it off, and ending with an entertaining World Series, and crowning the Houston Astros as the World Series champions for the first time ever. Thanks so much for watching. Please like and subscribe, and I hope you'll tune into the next episode.